The next chapter, hyperbola, one of the conics, hyperbola. Now, what is the definition of the hyperbola? The conic with eccentricity greater than 1 is called the hyperbola. Already we know that the conic with eccentricity equals to 1 is called the parabola, and the conic with eccentricity less than 1 is called the ellipse, and this is the conic with eccentricity greater than 1. So, this is the hyperbola. This is the definition of the conic. The locus of a point that moves so that the ratio of its distance from fixed point to its distance from the fixed line is greater than 1 is called the hyperbola. Is constant, then that is said to be the conic. Here we take the value greater than 1. Now this is called the hyperbola. And the graphical representation of the hyperbola is like this. In hyperbola, we have two curves which are the symmetric curves. This is the first curve and this is the second curve. This is the directrix that is corresponding to the first focus, and this is the directrix that is corresponding to the second focus S dash. Here also we have two focus points S comma S dash. Now here S shed is the perpendicular drawn from focus to the directrix, and the line S shed cuts the hyperbola at the point A, and the extended line of S shed cuts the curve at the point A dash. Now we take the midpoint of A dash, which is taken as the center of the hyperbola, that is C. And we are drawing one line which is perpendicular to A dash and passing to the point C. And we are taking these two lines as x axis and y axis. Therefore, the center of the hyperbola is nothing but 0, 0 here. And we take the distance between the point C and A is equals to A, and this distance between C and A dash is equals to A, since this is the midpoint of these two points. Now, this is the graphical representation of the hyperbola. Now, deducing the equation of the hyperbola in the standard form. Now, equation of the hyperbola in the standard form is, this is the equation, x square by a square minus y square by b square is equals to 1. The only difference between the ellipse and hyperbola is, in case of ellipse, we have the plus sign here, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to 1. But in case of hyperbola, we take minus sign, x square by a square minus y square by b square is equals to 1. Now, equation of hyperbola in the standard form, this is the diagram. S is the focus and S shed is the perpendicular from S to the directrix, and let A dash is equals to 2A. We are taking this total value is equals to 2A. Then CA is equal to CA dash is equal to small a, since C is the midpoint of the points A comma A dash. Since A is a point on the hyperbola, we apply the definition. What is the definition? SA by AZ is equals to A. Since A is a point on the hyperbola, we have SA by AZ is equals to A. That implies SA is equals to A into AZ. So equation 1. Again we apply the definition, that is SA dash by A dash Z is equals to E. That is SA dash is equals to E into A dash Z, which is equation 2. From these two equations, then SA plus SA dash is equals to E into AZ plus A dash Z. Now what is SA value? From the diagram, SA is equal to CS minus CA. CS minus CA plus SA dash. SA dash is equals to CS plus CA dash. CS plus CA dash is equals to E into AZ plus A dash Z. It is equals to AA dash. CA and CA dash are equal, so these two are cancelled. Now CS plus CS. 2CS is equals to E into AA dash. What is AA dash value? 2A. Therefore, the value of CS is equals to AE. Therefore, focus S is equals to AE comma 0. CS is equals to AE. Then the focus S is equals to AE comma 0, since it's a point on the x-axis. Now, subtracting the equations 1 and 2, second equation minus first equation, that is SA dash minus SA is equals to E into A dash Z minus AZ. And this is equals to SA dash minus SA. So, SA dash minus SA is nothing but AA dash. AA dash is equals to E into A dash Z. A dash Z is equal to CA dash plus CZ minus of AZ. AZ is equal to CA minus CZ. That is minus CA plus CZ. Here also CA dash and CA gets cancelled. And the value of AA dash is equal to 2A. 2A is equal to E into 2CZ. Therefore, the value of CZ is equal to A by A. Therefore, equation of directrix is x is equals to a by e. We are finding the equation of the hyperbola in the standard form. For that, first we take that let p is equal to x comma y be any point in the hyperbola. S is equals to a comma 0, and equation of directrix is x minus a by a is equal to 0. Now applying the definition here, by definition of the hyperbola we have that sp by pm is equals to e, that is sp is equals to e into pm. Then what is sp by distance between the points s and p, that is x minus a whole square plus y minus 0 whole square is equals to e into pm, perpendicular distance from x comma y to the directrix. The modulus x minus a by e by 1, squaring on both sides, then we get x minus a whole square plus y square is equals to e square into x minus a by e whole square. Now taking LCM here we get e square into x e minus e whole square by e square. X square plus a square e square minus 2x a e plus y square is equals to x square e square plus a square minus 2x a e. Now here 2x a e term gets cancelled. Now writing the remaining terms. So first we are writing the constants here, that is a square e square minus a square is equals to x square e square minus x square minus y square, writing these two terms to that side, which implies taking a square common here, a square into a square minus 1 is equals to x square into a square minus 1 minus y square. Now dividing this total equation by this value, that is 1 is equals to x square into a square minus 1 minus y square by a square into a square minus 1. Now separating the denominator here, x square into a square minus 1 by a square into a square minus 1 minus y square by a square into a square minus 1 equals to 1. That is x square by a square minus y square by a square into a square minus 1 equals to 1. Now we are taking this total value as b square here, that is let b square is equals to a square into a square minus 1. Then we get the equation as x square by a square minus y square by b square is equals to 1. So in hyperbola, the value of e greater than 1. If e greater than 1, then e square greater than 1. That is the value e square minus 1 greater than 0. So further we are taking this total value as b square. Therefore the equation is x square by a square minus y square by b square is equals to 1. Conversely, we take that equation of hyperbola is x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1. Now we want to show that sp by pm is equals to e. So x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1 means x square by a square minus 1 is equal to y square minus b square. By taking LCM, we get x square minus a square by a square is equal to y square by what is b square value a square into a square minus 1. Now by taking the cross product, we get the value of y square as x square minus a square into a square minus 1. Now we take the value of SP. SP is equals to what is SP, distance between the points S and P, that is square root of x minus a e whole square plus y square, which is equals to square root of x square plus a square e square minus 2x a e plus y square. What is y square value? X square minus a square into e square minus 1. And this is equals to square root of x square plus a square e square minus 2x a e plus x square e square minus a square e square minus x square plus a square. Now here plus x square minus x square plus a square e square minus a square e square gets cancelled. Now writing the remaining values, x square e square minus 2x a e plus a square, which is nothing but square root of x e minus a whole square, and that is equals to e into x minus a by e whole square equals to e into modulus x minus a e, that is sp is equals to e into pm, which implies the value of sp by pm is equals to e. Therefore, equation of the hyperbolic standard form is x square by a square minus y square by b square is equals to 1, where b square is equals to a square into e square minus 1. That's all.